I, Ajitem Chavan, from Genetics and Plant Breeding Group, pursuing for my PhD research work under the guidance of Dr. Subhadha Tamankar. My research topic is study of diverse semi-dwarfing genes in durum wheat.
Wheat is the second most important cereal in terms of the area and production. In India, three species of wheat are under cultivation, that is Triticum aestivum, Sarvati wheat, Triticum durum, Bansi, and Triticum dicocum, that is Khapli. Nowadays, Triticum aestivum wheat occupies about 90% area due to incorporation of RST-B1B and RST-D1B dwarfing genes derived from Norin 10 variety in 1960-70s, which brought green revolution in India. The durum wheats are mainly grown in the central and peninsular India for their suitability to semi-arid condition and heat stress. This wheat has lustrous bold grain, better disease resistance, utility for nutritional value products, and get higher price. Though the extensively used semi-dwarfing genes RST-B1B and RST-D1B doubled or tripled the yield by reduction in height, increasing tillering, fertilizer response, but the short coleoptile resulted in the poor germination under scarcity of moisture and deep sowing, which in turn reduces the yield. After Norin 10, many additional semi-dwarfing genes, either natural or mutant, were identified. Out of these, few have long coleoptiles and can emerge better in semi-arid condition. In the present research work, three induced mutant varieties, which are GA-sensitive, long coleoptiles carrying RST-14 gene, varieties Kesselpurjano, RST-15, that is Durox, and RST-18, Icaro, are used. These varieties are crossed with a tall, run-fed variety, Bijaga yellow, and irrigated semi-dwarf variety HI-8498 carrying RST-B1B gene. The recombinant inbred lines were developed in 6 combinations and stable superior genotypes were selected. These genotypes were evaluated with checks in replicated field trial under rain-fed and irrigated conditions for 3 successive years. The morphological, agronomical, physiological parameters were recorded at different stages. For physiological parameters, instruments like NDVI, SPAD, infrared thermometer, etc. were used.
30.4, 30.7, 30.3.
The root parameter study was also carried out for the selected genotypes. The grain quality parameter study is in progress. The analysis of the data is in progress to know the better genotype under respective environments. We can get the genotypes which have long coleoptiles with reduced height and will sustain the water stress and high temperature in these changing climatic conditions. Secondly, these genotypes will provide the diverse genetic background to face the adverse effects of the global warming. Thank you.